Hi there. Welcome to OSU Drupal Droplets. This is Joe Finn with Oregon State University's Web and Mobile Services. And today we are going to take a look at how to create a one column with background image paragraph bundle. So we're going to jump right in with a sample page that I created here. Just go ahead and click the Edit tab. So what's going to happen here when we open the form is we're going to look for a section here that says paragraph. Now, depending on who your architect is for your site, this could appear in a different position on your form. It might even be tucked away inside of something like a field set. Look around for the paragraph type field here. That's your indication that you've got paragraphs enabled and attached to your form. So that being said, what we're going to create is a one column background image here. And we just click the Add New Paragraph button. And you'll see that you get a field set that pops up that says one column paragraph. We've got a couple things here. First, we've got this content text area. So we want to put a little bit of text in here. And it just needs to be a little bit. Really, you only want a small paragraph. So I'm going to copy a little text here from Meet the Ipsums and paste it in. And maybe you want to have a header on top. If that's the case, you can go ahead and create that. And we will use a heading 3. And just make our fake text look a little more real. So scrolling down here, now that we've got our text in, we are going to choose background. So we want an image for this. And once we choose image, you see that we get some more buttons and drop down here. So what we're going to do is we're going to browse for an image. And we'll upload one from a desktop here. So one thing to note is you need media. You should really have your media prepared ahead of time. Now, the sizes might vary. We don't really have any lockdowns on the image sizes. For this particular image, I'm using an image that's 1920 pixels wide by 675 pixels tall. This is really kind of arbitrary, so use your best judgment. You might want to use an aspect ratio that's similar to what I have here. So we find our picture, open it up, and click upload, and then next. And we want to do a little media management here. So we're going to say Oregon State University Women's Basketball Team 2018-19. OSU Women's There we go. And hit save. And once it gets pulled up, we'll see a little thumbnail here. So now we got this style drop down. And for this particular thing, we don't want to repeat. We're just going to do just a plain straight image embed. And then you will also see this style button. So when it says content on the right or content on the left, what this means is where do we want this text to show? So what we'll do is we'll just put it on the right side, just for the sake of the example. Once that's all filled in, scroll down, hit save, and then you will see your text and your image. Now, one thing to notice, we've got our text here on the right-hand side, and it's covering over the image. So what you do want to be really aware of is the positioning of things that you're going to be laying out. So this particular image here probably wouldn't be great if we want to use the hero text. But you know, that's okay, because we can always go in and edit it. And we can remove the hero text if we want. We do not have to have that there. If we want to, we can just go with plain image, just like that. And that is our one column with background image paragraph bundle. So this is the first in a series of tutorials related to creating the specific paragraph bundles. Come and join us for our next one, which will be our two column paragraph bundle. This has been Joe Finn with Oregon State University's Web and Mobile Services. Hope to see you soon.